All right, okay, so hello, dears. Welcome now to the third part and hopefully the last video, no, of our pre-recorded lecture on stool specimens. All right, and for this part, we're going now to start with the first chemical preservative for preserving stool specimens, no, in times that or in cases when there is a delay in the examination, and that is for the first one is formalin. All right, so we ended in the last video with refrigeration, diba? Again, very common way of preserving stool specimens, but only temporary. All right. Now for formalin. Okay. Now, usually these chemical preservatives we use them for long-term purposes. Okay. Not all, but most of them also. But if usually we use for chemical preservative, our mind or like our rationale why we use it, it's usually for long-term purposes. Or aside from that, also for other lab procedures in the parasitology lab that entails preserved specimens, okay, using these chemical preservatives. All right, so we'll start first with formalin. Formalin is again an oxidation product, no, diba, of your formaldehyde. Okay, all right, of formaldehyde, diba. I joke, mali. Sorry, guys. Nako, org chem ko, kamusta na? Formalin DI is actually it's a formaldehyde that is in aqueous solution. So it is dissolved in water and iyahang volume or weight in volume is 37 to 40%. And formaldehyde DI. Formaldehyde is an oxidation product, diba? Oxidation product of methanol, diba? Of methanol or your methyl alcohol, diba? So recall in your org chem. I won't go deeper into this because that's not our lesson and I forgot already my org chem. But in a nutshell, formaldehyde, diba, is the oxidation product of your methanol. Okay, so this is a gas. But formalin, on the other hand, is an aqueous solution. So it's a formaldehyde gas dissolved in water, all right? And usually it's about 37 to 40% in weight in volume, and that is the stock solution of formalin. Stock solution, so meaning the stock solution or the mother solution in a way, or that is the solution that we get from the other concentration. So we base it from the stock solution, and then we make other concentrations from the stock solution depending on what we need. All right. So the stock solution is about 40%. Okay. All right. Ayan. And it's again an all-purpose fixative, not flour. All-purpose flour. Charot. All-purpose fixative. Why? Because again, it can preserve a lot. It's a fixative rather. It can preserve a variety of stuff. No, diba? Formalin can preserve humans even. It can even preserve animals, whatever. So it's an all-purpose fixative. By the name itself, it can be used for any purpose. Okay, and again, your stool sample is no exception to that. Okay, all right, and it can be buffered with sodium phosphate to help preserve morphological characteristics. So buffered with sodium phosphate, so you add a buffer, okay, so that it can facilitate in the preserving of morphological characteristics. All right, and formalin again, you'll encounter that in your third year histotechnology. This is again one of the most common, if not the most common, used fixative. Okay, or preservative for human tissues, when we process human tissues in the laboratory for biopsy, for other tests. Okay, all right, you'll know that in your third year. Okay, all right, ayan. Two concentrations for parasitology are used. The first one is 5%, and it's usually used if we want to preserve protozoan cysts. All right, because the trophozoites are destroyed by formalin. Okay, and 10% for helminths, eggs, and larvae. Now, I have a mnemonic this for this before na ginamit ko when I was a third year student. You have 5C, okay, and 10H. So, mara siyang jeep sa Cebu, joke lang. All right, 5C lang, 5C. Because during my time, 2017, third year ko, medyo bago pa yung iPhone 5C. So, medyo dali lang siya ma-remember. So, kung 5C, 5% for cysts. And therefore, kung 5% ang cysts, a helminth is the other one, 10%. Ayan. So, inana na lang siya pag-memorize. So, 5C, 10H. So, 5% ang protozoan cysts, 5C, and 10% for helminth eggs and larvae. Okay? Alright. Ayan. Of course, we have some advantages. Number one is it's easy to prepare. Number two, it can preserve specimens for up to several years. That's why, again, it's really commonly used because, again, it can preserve for a long time, okay? And lastly, long shelf life. When you say long shelf life, dili siya long iyahang validity, okay? Or it can be used for a long period of time. So it does not expire immediately. Okay, all right. But its disadvantages, it does not preserve morphology for permanent stained smears. Again, this is a lesson that we will discuss when we stain mga smears from fecal specimens, right? It does not preserve morphology. Morphologic details may fade over time. It can interfere with PCR, di ba? PCR, your polymerase chain reaction. So this is a molecular biologic technique. Okay, all right. So again, you'll have that in your third year, and I think you're familiar with this because of, di ba, COVID-19 and how we detect COVID-19. That's RT-PCR. That's another example of another method of PCR. Okay, RT stands for reverse transcriptase. Okay, so this is an enzyme that is usually found in mga viruses, or we use that to convert the genome of the virus to the genome of humans. Okay, para mas easy siya magpadaghan, or it's easier to amplify, because your PCR is a molecular technique that amplifies or yahang padaghan nun, or it amplifies the genome material, genetic material of the specimen. Okay, all right. So example, DNA, padaghan niya ang DNA, ang RNA na lang. Okay, all right. And RT-PCR, reverse transcriptase. Okay, all right. Anyway, ayan. But again, formalin can interfere with that. And lastly, is that disadvantage, it can present as a health hazard. So it can be deadly or it can be harmful to our health. Okay, because again, because it's a gas, it's a chemical put. All right. Okay, ayan. And we have a concentration technique or a technique in parasitology that uses formalin as your preservative. And that is known as your formalin ether concentration technique. So we'll have a different discussion on this when we go to concentration technique. So when you say concentration, we want to padaghan or we want to concentrate our specimen. So we want to acquire or get all the parasites that we can from the specimen. Okay, all right. So formalin ether or ethyl acetate. So again, don't worry. We'll discuss this later on sa atong course. Okay. Formalin ether ethyl acetate concentration technique. Okay, so by the name itself, it uses formalin. All right, so that's for the first preservative. The next one is what we call your polyvinyl alcohol or PVA. PVA or polyvinyl alcohol. Now, what is PVA? It's a plastic powder that is usually used as an adhesive. Okay, so PVA, generally, guys, it's an adhesive. So when you say adhesive, pampataput, okay? It's used as an adhesive for the stool specimen when preparing glass slides, for smears or for examination. So it's an adhesive so that the stool specimen can adhere properly on the slide, all right? So that it will not be removed, especially during staining, okay? Because the staining can introduce a lot of chemicals that can lead to the removal of the stool from the slides. So you want that the stools are well adhered to the slides, so you use an adhesive, and that is polyvinyl alcohol. But also, it can also be used as a preservative. All right? Okay. Again, it's most often combined with Chaudine's solution, which contains zinc sulfate, copper sulfate, or mercury chloride. Ayan. So Chaudine's solution is another preservative that we'll look into later. But please take note the composition. It has mercuric chloride, because again, this will be one of the disadvantages of this preservative. All right. Excellent fixative for preservation of morphologic features of protozoa, as well as in particular trophozoid stages. All right. Ayan. So advantages lang, it can be used for permanent stain smear. So if you want that your specimen, you want to make smears, or you want to make parang permanent ba for long-term purposes, no, for future purposes, you can still look at the specimen. So you create smears, you stain them, okay? All right? Meaning you put color to the specimen, all right? So you can use this preservative. So preparation of permanent stained smears, and preserved specimens have a long shelf life. So your specimens can does not easily deteriorate. Okay, it can withstand the test of time, Char. For a long shelf life, meaning it does not deteriorate rapidly if they are stored at room temperature, RT. Room temperature. Okay, all right. And disadvantages lang, recovery of parasites from concentration techniques, diba, is not as effective when you use formalin. And potential health problems, as mentioned, from mercuric chloride. Because again, mercury can be toxic, no? So that is why there are a lot of modifications to PVA. Because again, it contains mercuric chloride. All right? Ayan. So when combined with Shodin solution. So we now go to the modifications. You have many laboratories, because again, diba, we mentioned that it's not as effective in concentration techniques as formalin. That is why some laboratories opted to have a two-vial system, wherein one vial is formalin ang preservative, and the second one is PVA. Because formalin is for concentration technique, the sample there, and the sample in the PVA is for permanent stain smears. Okay? Ayan. And we have a modified PVA. When you say modified, so of course, alternate to the PVA. And instead of using mercuric chloride, it's now containing copper sulfate or zinc sulfate. But its disadvantage is that the quality of the permanent stain smears is not as good as those that are used or those that are prepared from mercury-based fixatives. So the quality of the smear is not as good. Kung kaysa atong nigamit ka og Shodin solution na that has mercuric chloride. Okay, that's lang the disadvantage. All right, another one, EcoFix. Ayan, so another board exam recall question. Not during our time, but previous board exams. What is the eco-friendly preservative? Eco-friendly lang. And that is EcoFix. Okay, and the question is, what type of preservative is that? Is it PVA? Is it formalin? Blah, blah, blah. So the answer is PVA. Please take note, okay? Ayan, all right. And another one is the total fix, which contains no mercury, it contains no formalin, and even no PVA. So it's just a universal fixative. So what do you mean by universal? It can preserve, no? The goal is that it preserves the protozoan, usually. The trophozoites and the cysts, okay? It's a combination of ingredients coming from zinc, but it is derived from a proprietary formula. Okay, all right. Proprietary formula. So when you say proprietary formula, it's like it's a well-known formula of, like, example, PVA, but then they modified in a way so that it would be less harmful or that it would be unique to their brand, example, like that. Okay, so they based it on a formula already that is already there, and then they modified some stuff there. Okay, all right, so that's total fix. Universal fixative, eco-friendly. Ayan. So it's still eco-friendly, universal fixative. But the question sa boards lang is eco-friendly lang. Walay universal fixative. Okay? So the answer there is EcoFix, and that is an example of a PVA, polyvinyl alcohol. Alright. Again, these two are taken from Bailey and Scott's. Alright? As mentioned, diba, most of the board of examiners get their questions there. Alright? So yeah. Okay. So I included na lang. And this is an example of a two-vial system. One for formalin. So you put a stool there, and then you put a part of the stool specimen here, and the other part is there is a PVA. All right. Again, for the purpose that the formalin fixed specimen is for concentration techniques, and for PVA, it's for your permanent stain smears. Okay. All right. Next, we have the methylate iodine formaldehyde. So it's an MIF or MIF na siya. Okay. MIF. All right. Iba yung MILF. Joke lang. MIF. Okay. All right. Methylate iodine formaldehyde. Okay. All right. So methylate iodine formaldehyde, it's an interesting stain. It's an interesting preservative because it fixes and stains. So it's a preservative, and at the same time, it stains or it gives color to your fecal specimen. So it's used especially in field surveys. So example, when you go to the field, like you go to communities, you go to different areas, no, in the public. And then you have like a lot of specimens. So it's good that you already have a fixative or a chemical that can preserve and at the same time also stain already. So it's like hitting two birds with one stone, diba? So that's much easier, especially in field surveys, because in field surveys, there can be a lot of specimens, no? So it can be quite taxing and strenuous for the laboratory personnel that you know, after fixing or after preserving, you still need to stain individually. So at least if you have this, you can already accomplish two tasks at once. Okay? All right. Ayan. Okay. So it preserves all stages of helminths and protozoa, as well as it stains for protozoas for better identification. All right. And but care must be exercised in removing fecal material so that there's not much of liquid or too much liquid will be included pagtanggal sa fecal specimen. All right. And the iodine component, di ba, is quite unstable and it's not applicable still for concentration procedures. So the merthiolate and the iodine serves as the stains. Okay, merthiolate or also known as thimerosal. Okay, thimerosal. These two serve as the stains. Okay, and formaldehyde is of course the what do you call that? The preservative. Okay, all right. Ayan. So again, advantages: easy to prepare, long shelf life. Again, components both stain and fix or preserve the organisms. And lastly, disadvantages: iodine can interfere with other stains. It's not suitable, again, for some permanent stains. If you stain it with the trichrome stain, that's a type of stain, trichrome. And iodine may also cause distortion or it may cause the damage to protozoa. Okay, all right, ayan. Merthiolate, iodine, formaldehyde. Okay, next is, of course, the shodins. Okay, unsa gani ang medyo downside ani niya? It contains mercuric chloride. Again, it preserves fresh stool or fresh fecal sample. It provides excellent preservation of protozoa, trophozoites, and cysts. For many years, this is considered as the gold standard. So when you say gold standard, it's like the reference method or the top of the top, the inspiration, or something that is really like at the top, or like something that's really something that is used as a basis for the others. Ganyan. So gold standard, okay, for the many years, Shodin's solution. But again, it contains mercuric chloride, which is highly toxic to humans. Advantage lang is easy preparation of permanent stain smears, so you can prepare permanent stain smears easily. But again, the disadvantage, it's not suitable for concentration procedures, poor adhesion, so meaning your liquid specimens do not adhere that much on the slide. So there are instances where it can lead to the removal of the specimen on your slide, no? So you cannot examine anything anymore, okay? All right, and aside from that, again, the main disadvantage is the mercuric chloride, okay? That is why there are modifications done with Shodin solution, okay? That it doesn't use as mercuric chloride anymore, like maybe copper or other less, other non-toxic na mga chemicals. All right, that's Shodin's solution. Okay, and the last preservative is sodium acetate formaldehyde, SAF. It's an alternative to Shodin's, 10% formalin as fixative and sodium acetate, which is the buffer. All right, okay. Easy to prepare, eliminates again the use of mercuric compounds, which is again a really bad or a downside of the previous natin na mga preservatives, Shodin's and your PVA, okay. And advantage is compatible with immunoassay kits. So when you say again immunoassay, you detect for antigens or antibodies. So involving the immune system, no? Again, that's our last topic in the laboratory. Okay, mga immunoassays for parasitic diseases. And it's suitable for acid fast and safranine stains. Acid fast is, this is a method of staining. So this is a staining method generally used for detection of tuberculosis. Okay? Because it detects the causative agent of tuberculosis, which is Mycobacterium tuberculosis, acid fast. Okay. All right. That's a stain. Generally, the general use of acid fast is for this. Okay? This will be discussed in your third year bacteriology. But in parasitology, there are some parasites that are acid fast also. All right? And these parasites are known as your coccidians. Okay. All right. So acid fast. Coccidians. Alright, they are still under protozoa. So example, you have Cryptosporidium. You have Cyclospora. And lastly, you have Isospora. Cystoisospora. Cystoisospora. Alright. Or some would say it as Isospora lang. Alright, so these are coccidians. Alright, so I think we'll discuss acid fast na stain when we go to staining of fecal smears. All right. So these are example of acid fast, partially acid fast na ano organisms, partially lang, partially acid fast. So they are not really that the true acid fast, because the true acid fast is Mycobacterium tuberculosis or Mycobacterium species. Okay. Kani sila partially lang, so mga 50%, mga ganun. So again, we'll discuss this. I think this is included in permanent stain, permanent smears, staining of fecal smears for permanent stain smears, ganun. All right, okay, ayan. And disadvantages, requires an additive for adhesion. So you need another chemical or another material, and usually that is albumin, glycerin. All right. Again, its purpose is for adhesion, so that your specimen will be fixed or will stick, okay, to the slide, so that you can examine. You can examine it under the microscope, or that it will not be removed during staining or other processes. All right, and permanent stains not as good as PVA or Shodin's fixative, so it's better if you use the iron hematoxylin stains, okay? All right, because again, there are other stains, example. Oh, wait. Baka hindi na klaro. Alright. So, again, if you use this fixative, SAF, you use dapat stains na iron hematoxylin. Because if you use trichrome, Wheatley, trichrome, it's not as effective. Okay? So, this preservative is only better or it's only good if you use the stain that is iron hematoxylin and not Whitley's trichrome. Yeah, Whitley's trichrome. Okay? All right. Please take note, guys. Ayan. Okay. And lastly, for transport, there are some cases that, you know, your laboratory cannot cater, no, to some tests or cannot identify the parasite. So you need to send out or you need to transport this stool specimen to what we call your specialized laboratories or reference laboratories. All right. Now, when you transport, you should put it in a Ziploc plastic bag. All right. Again, for specialized or what we say, reference laboratories, because again, these laboratories have the capability to really identify, like to the most difficult. All right, because they have special techniques, they have special training then on how to identify them. No, so those are really good. Like examples, the CDC. Examples. NKTI, National Kidney Transplant Institute, you have East Avenue Medical Center, RITM, of course. So, example, like mga reference laboratories in the Philippines, di ba? Alright, okay, ayan. So, again, when you transport, these are some preservatives that you can use. 10% formalin for wet mouth, so this is the formula, 1 part stool plus 3 parts formalin. You should place in the vial, crush the stool thoroughly, and then it preserves the specimen indefinitely if the bottle is closed. You can also use MIF or methylate iodine formaldehyde for wet mouth. 4.7 ml of MIF plus 0.3 ml of Lugol's iodine, okay, in a vial or bottle just before dispatching. And then you add 2 ml of stool, crush it, and then preserve the specimen indefinitely. And lastly, of PVA for permanent staining. So 30 ml of PVA or 3/4 full plus enough fresh stool to fill the container. And then break the stool with a stick and cover and preserves all the forms of parasites indefinitely. And this is an example of a picture of a Ziploc bag that can be used for transport. So as you can see, of course, there's the biohazard symbol, all right? And the specimen bag, and how is it transported? Frozen bar, room temperature, or refrigerator, a refrigerated temperature. Okay, all right. And some summary of general points, okay? Again, number one, stools after enemas are suitable for examination of worms, eggs, and protozoan parasites. So just general points in stool examination. Number two, as mentioned, those taking oil laxatives, barium, bismuth salts, not suitable for examination. You should delay it after how many days? 5 to 7 days. And specifically for barium, according to Bailey and Scott, 5 to 10. Okay, all right. Urine, again, kills protozoa, atrophozoites, so never accept stool mixed with urine. Stool, again, should not be contaminated with water, for it will speed up the growth of non-pathogenic organisms. Or, again, it can introduce free-living nematodes, protozoa, that could lead to misdiagnosis. Trophozoites and cysts appear again in stool at intervals, diba? So it's not that they appear all the time. It can appear maybe 1 or 2 days after, like that. All right. So a series of several specimens should be ruled out for a negative result, diba? Diba? Pila to, 3 specimens for up to 10 days. Okay. Number 6, form stools again. Cysts, watery, contain trophozoites. Just remember the environment. Your trophozoites, they like swimming, no? They have mga locomotory organs, so they like an environment that is liquid, that is fluid. All right, so watery diarrhea sila makitaan. Okay, all right. Number 7, prompt examination of specimen has to be observed to prevent disintegration. Never leave a specimen exposed to air, and of course, never freeze stool samples nor keep them in incubators. All right, so again, before the IWN for the preservatives, as you may have noticed, there's not a best preservative. Each of it has their disadvantages and advantages. So again, the choice of the fixative or preservative depends on the laboratory. But if you are asked, what is that fixative that is preservative that's really good for permanent stain smears? All right, it's usually PVA. All right, and those that are compatible with immunoassay kits, can you remember? Compatible with immunoassay kits, the sodium acetate formaldehyde. All right, what concentration of formalin can be used to preserve protozoan cysts? You have 5%, 5C. And for helminth eggs and larvae, 10%. Okay, all right. So basically, guys, that's the end of our presentation on stool specimens. The first part pa lang, okay? All right, because again, in the later part, we will discuss now on how to process the stool in terms of macroscopic, and then from there, we then create smears out of it or wet mounts, okay? Later, in the later part of the semester or in our course, okay? All right, so again, in that part, you will now be taught, or you will know how to describe your consistency. Is it hard? Is it semi-formed? Is it mushy? Is it, yeah, all that stuff, okay? So prepare lang. But again, that's all for stool specimens, the intro to the stool specimens, or like the basics, in terms of their collection, handling, preservation, and lastly, the transport. Okay, all right, so I hope the discussion is quite clear and that you understood the lessons. Again, if you have any question, just feel free to chat in our group chat, or PM me wherever in social media, or again, the open forum in our soul, in your soul sections, or soul accounts, all right? So, ayun. So, ayun, guys. Hopefully, nalingaw ra mo. Medyo gamay ra kong jokes karon. But anyway, yes. So, thank you so much, dears, for watching and listening, and have a great day, guys. Keep safe, and God bless.